Okay, so this is just a little update of what's going on. This is a little update of what's going on. The sun is washing me out. What's going on with update of my life and update of my lupus. So with my lupus right now, I'm doing okay. Well, I'm doing pretty good. I just left the doctor's. Actually just sitting in the parking lot at the doctor's office right now. I am washed out. The sun, oh my God, the sun is washing out. I'm gonna have to probably move. But I just left the doctor's office. Everything is looking pretty good except my urine analysis came back kind of abnormal. What did he say? He said I had some crystals or something in my kidneys. I don't know. So now he's making me take, he's telling me I need to take some calcium pills. So I'm gonna have to go get some calcium. What else? But other than that, I'm doing pretty good. I don't think I've ever went over like the exact medications that I was going, that I'm on right now. Let me see if it's listed in this paper. Because I know some people are on different medications, because some medications work for some and some work for, doesn't work for others. So currently I am taking, what am I taking? I'm trying to find it. For my lupus, I'm currently taking Plaquenil, which is the hydrochloroquine, the medication that Donald Trump tried to say cured COVID, and it does not cure COVID. So I'm taking that every day. I'm taking the Celset, which is, the technical term is mycophenolate, whatever, but it's the Celset. I'm taking that every day. And I was taking prednisone, but he just told me that I do not have to take prednisone anymore, thank God. So I'm off of the prednisone. I was tapering off of that. I was at 20 milligrams when I left the hospital. I think I was on 60 milligrams when I was in the hospital, and then I was on 20 when I left. And then in January, he put me down to 10. And then February, he put me down to 5. And then now he said that I can get off of it, so I don't have to take the prednisone anymore. It is hot. Let me take this jacket off. And I forgot to mention in my lupus story video that I actually developed Raynaud's syndrome or Raynaud's disease or something, like whatever it's called, Raynaud's something. I actually developed that, and that is basically when I get cold, I lose oxygen in my hands. I think that's the correct definition of it or whatever, but I lose oxygen in my hands and my hands turn blue. Like the first time it happened, it freaked me out. If I can insert the pictures, I will. The first time it happened, it freaked me out. I was like, what the hell is going on? And my hands, like both of my hands were just blue. And I had just, all I did was wash my hands, and I kind of got cold from that. And my hands turned blue. So I get cold very easily. Oh, and I didn't say I'm also on folic acid and vitamin D, because if you have lupus, most likely you're vitamin D deficient, and I was or am vitamin D deficient, because I can't get my vitamin D from the sun, because sun causes lupus flares, cause rashes, so I can't be out in the sun for extended periods of time, and if I am out in the sun, I have to have on sunscreen and like protective, like a jacket or hat or something like that. So, but I just try to avoid the sun at all costs because I'm not trying to have a flare. So yeah, I'm on vitamin D. And then he just told me I had to take calcium, so I got to eat some calcium. What else? I think that's it. But yeah, the Raynards, it's so annoying. Like, I touch anything cold, ice, anything out the freezer. If I get cold, it's just, oh my God, my hands turn blue. They get kind of numb and they hurt a little bit. So yeah, I developed that. Apparently I have crystals in my kidneys right now, so I have to drink more water, which I was telling him, I was like, I drink water all the time. That's all I drink. So I have to drink water and take some calcium. What else? And I'm reducing my office visits now. So he said I'm getting a lot better. So I'm able to reduce my office visits. I was going once a month. Now I think he has me going every 2 months now, because right, he scheduled my next appointment until May. So I don't have to go back until May. I was going back every month. But I also see a cardiologist. I mentioned that. So I'm taking something. I don't know how to pronounce these medications. Metoprolol, whatever. Because once I got diagnosed, my heart rate was like through the roof. Like, no matter what, I would just be sitting down doing nothing, laying down in the bed doing nothing, and my heart rate would be at like 150, and that's not good at all. So I was taking that to like help reduce my heart rate. I was supposed to get an MRI done last month, February 5th. I went to go get that MRI done. Something happened. I wasn't able to get it done, so I was going to reschedule it. But then a week later, my sister passed away. I mentioned in my lupus story video, if you haven't seen that video, and then you have absolutely no idea what I'm talking about, then you need to watch that video first. But I mentioned in my lupus story video that I have a twin sister. And she was helping me through my lupus journey and all of that. And unfortunately, she passed away a week after I was supposed to get my MRI done. So I was gonna reschedule the MRI, but my sister passed away unexpectedly. So I've kind of been slacking on like my medical stuff. I kind of been slacking on it. So, but yeah, I don't really want to get too much into that, because that's really sensitive to me. But she did pass away unexpectedly. So I've been dealing with that. So the stress of that, I was highly anticipating a lupus flare after that, but I haven't. Thank God I have not had a lupus flare since then. And that was, she passed away a month ago. So now she was, like I said, she was the one that was helping me through my lupus. Somebody's pulling beside me. And they look, they're about to hit my car. He's really close. He's really, really close. But yeah, so she was the one that was helping me through my lupus journey. And he's like really, really close. But yeah, so now I'm kind of on my own doing this by myself. Cause she was the one coming to my appointments with me and just helping me throughout this whole thing, helping me with medical, any changes he wanted me to do. Me and her would discuss it, try to weigh the pros and cons, and she was just the one that I would consult this stuff with. But now I'm kind of having to do it by myself, because right before she, like a couple of weeks before she passed, my doctor was recommending me to take this drug called Benlysta. And at first he wanted me to do the infusion. He wanted me to go to the hospital once a month and do an infusion. It would be like an hour and a half of this infusion. I was really nervous about doing that because I was looking up the drug or the medicine, drug, whatever you want to call it. I was looking it up and I wasn't really sure if that's something I wanted to do. So me and her was kind of discussing that. And then he said that if I didn't want to do the infusion, because this drug is expensive and I would have to do it once a month for a long period of time. And it's expensive. It's really, really expensive. Even with insurance, it's hella expensive. And I just could not afford it because it was just ridiculously expensive. Like I say, even with insurance, it's hella expensive. And I would have to get that done monthly. So I was like, yeah, that's kind of pricey. And I'm kind of feeling good right now. So if I don't absolutely have to have it, then can we like hold off on it? So then he recommended me do these self-injections. And I was not really trying to do that. And so me and her were kind of discussing the pros and cons. And she was like talking to one of her coworkers who has Crohn's disease, who also does self-injections. It's a different medication, but she does self-injections as well. And so she was talking to her coworker about it and like the experience and things like that. And we was just both basically trying to weigh the pros and cons. And I didn't want to self-inject myself because that's just weird and I don't want to do that. So she was talking about, she was like, well, I'll do it, I'll learn how to do it, and we can just try to do it together and things like that. So so now that she has passed, I'm trying to like making these decisions by myself. And I really don't want to do this because he mentioned the Benlysta again today. And I just don't really want to take it right now. I just don't know how I feel about doing self-injections. Because I know it's either in the thigh or in the stomach. And I just don't want to do it by myself. And I would just feel a lot more comfortable if my sister was here to, you know, kind of help me with it. But now I'm like on my own. So, I don't know. So I'm just trying to figure out what I'm gonna do and things like that. So yeah. I need to go to the hospitals to do this blood work. So I'm gonna go get this blood work done. Hopefully it comes back okay. But yeah, so let me get this blood work done. This is just a little update of what's going on and what's happening, and yeah, so that's it. So I'll talk to you guys next time. Peace. Okay, I'm actually at the hospital now, but I actually wanted to mention this as well. I forgot to mention this earlier, but because it was something that my sister actually wanted me to mention in my last video, but I wasn't really ready to talk about it yet. And I'm still not fully ready to talk about it, but I will mention it. Just for people who are diagnosed with lupus or just now diagnosed with lupus. I just wanted to mention that not only did I have physical effects of lupus, I also had some psychological effects as well. Like I said, I don't want to go too much into it because I'm not too ready to talk about it. But I just wanted to put that out there for people who are just now being diagnosed, that they don't think that they're by themselves, and that it's pretty common to also have some psychological effects of being diagnosed with lupus or any disease or anything. But I did have some psychological effects. I did develop anxiety and depression while I was in the hospital. I did have to take medication for that. I know I was taking Xanax while I was in the hospital, and they also prescribed me, I can't even remember what the other medicine was for. It was basically, it was sleeping pills, but it was also for depression as well. I don't even remember what the name was, but they just prescribed me that and the Xanax. I did take the Xanax while I was in the hospital, and they did prescribe me the sleeping pills, but I'm just not a person that really likes to take medication, especially for stuff like that. I have to take medication now because I have lupus and I have to take the medication, but for something like the depression and anxiety, I was just would rather do that on my own, try to fix that, not on my own, but naturally, as far as like therapy and things like that, and just try to work with it naturally instead of just taking a pill to fix it, because a pill does not get to the root of the problem. So I've been in therapy since January, helping me with, what's that noise? Helping me with the anxiety and depression that I developed while when being diagnosed. And now I'm actually glad that I'm in therapy, because I'm also having to deal with the anxiety and depression of losing my sister. So I am in therapy. It has been helping. It's been helping a lot. Well, prior to my sister passing, it's been helping me get through my lupus and like talk my feelings out and talk my anxieties and my fears and all of that stuff. So it has been helping me mentally as well. So if you do have any disease, but I'm speaking of lupus in particular, get you a therapist. If it is messing with you mentally, get you a therapist. And just it's you not only have to work through your physical health, you have to work through your mental health as well. I'm sitting in this hospital parking lot because I need to take this urine test and I need to pee, and I don't have to pee, so I'm trying to drink the water so that I can pee. But yeah, so if you have any psychological effects, that's pretty normal. So don't feel like, oh, like I'm crazy or anything. But yeah, I did, like I said, I did develop some psychological, like I said, I don't want to get too much into it because it was just a lot. I didn't have panic attacks and all that. But like I said, I don't want to get too much into it because it was kind of sensitive for me. And I was actually like a couple of days, like when I released my first video, my twin sister, she actually wanted to do another video because she said that I actually left some stuff out, because like I said, I couldn't remember. I didn't hardly remember a lot of stuff because effects of lupus is what they call brain fogs or lupus fogs, where you forget things or you get confused. And I got that a lot. Like I was confused. There was times where I didn't even know where I was or what I was doing or what was going on. So and like I said, my twin sister, she was there. So when she was watching the video back, she was like, girl, you done missed some stuff. You left some stuff out. So she was actually going to film a video together so that she could fill in some stuff, because apparently I forgot things. But she's not here to do that now. So yeah, I just gotta go with what I said. But yeah, I just wanted to mention the psychological aspect of having lupus and how it did affect me. But that has gotten a lot better. But I don't know how it'll be if I get a flare again, if I flare up again. I don't know how it will be. So I will keep you guys updated on that for as much as I feel comfortable sharing. Yeah, so I'll keep you updated on that. But I think that's it. I think I'm done now. I need to go into this hospital and get this blood work and urine test. And I need to eat because I haven't eaten anything. And it is 1:30. And I haven't eaten a thing. So I'm going to go So yeah, I think I'm done this time. So I will talk to you guys later, and I'll keep you guys updated of my how my lupus is going and how I'm dealing with it. So I will talk to you guys later.